Welcome to the demonstration of NetSuite Smart Count. I'm logged in as a Smart Count inventory counter. With proper permissions, I'll access Smart Count on a mobile handheld device with touchscreen and barcode scanning capability so that I can begin an item count. Here, I can only see warehouse locations to which I have access. I'll select my Denver warehouse to start the count. On the Smart Count mobile screen, I have a list of all the items and bin locations that are scheduled to be counted today, signified by the count hyperlink in the action column. I'll click count next to the first task to begin counting. Smart Count takes the on-hand inventory snapshot at the time the count link is clicked. This allows for the tracking of any on-hand changes to inventory between the time the count is taken and when it is approved. To record this first count, I'll scan the bin and scan the item number or UPC code. Once Smart Count validates the item number, I'll enter the quantity, accept the default inventory status and unit of measure, and click Complete. As we can see, the item we just counted moves to the bottom of the list. It's labeled as Done in the Action column, and the quantity and inventory status is listed in the Current Count column. If necessary, the user can go back and make changes to the count before it's approved. I will now repeat the process for the remaining items. In addition to allowing the user to manually key in the count quantity, Smart Count can be configured to force the user to tally scan each item being counted as well. All counts on the task list have been completed and each are now in done status. From here, I'll switch roles and review the count as the Smart Count inventory manager. Here on the Smart Count review page, I can filter the list of counts pending approval by several criteria. I have some KPIs for the counts that have yet to be approved, and I have the list of item counts themselves. The item count report displays the bin where the count took place, the item counted in the bin, and any on-hand change that may have occurred while the count was active. Additionally, it shows the recorded count quantity, the count quantity variance, and the dollar cost of the variance, if any. Each count also has a status associated with it, system remarks that give more detail about the state of the count, and the reason the count took place. We can see here that three of the counts are 100% accurate, and two of the counts have variances. Both variances are highlighted in red because they exceed the tolerance threshold set for each of those items. Variance tolerances can be set at the company level and/or the item level. If we look on the inventory count subtab of the item location configuration record for one of the items, we can see four tolerance fields. Quantity tolerance is the number value of the maximum allowable variance, and amount tolerance is the dollar value of the maximum allowable tolerance. Quantity percentage tolerance represents the maximum allowable quantity variance as a percentage of the total on-hand quantity. The amount percentage tolerance represents the maximum allowable dollar value as a percentage of the total value of the quantity on hand. In the case of this item, it's 5% of the total on-hand quantity or 10% of the dollar value of the total on-hand quantity. I'll now go back and address the item counts that are waiting for approval. Back on the count review page, I can select all item counts, individual counts, or any combination of each, and approve, reject, or send back to the counter for a recount. From here, I'll select the three counts that are pending approval and approve them. I'll then reject one count and send the last count back for a recount. I'll now go back to the task list on the Smart Count mobile screen to see the result of the approval process we just went through. I can see that the item we rejected is no longer on the list, and the item we sent back for recount is in count status under the action column. Thank you for watching this demonstration. If you have any questions, please reach out to your account manager.